lived in Sean McDermott Street in one room. We got a letter to say that we got a flat in Michael's to stay in Inchicore, and I asked where was that, because I lived in the city, so it was like coming out of the country. But one thing I did find hard when I came, my rent was 8 shillings, and when I came over here, it was £3.93.
And a lot of people came back that had moved out, like they got transfers back.
I'm living in St Michael's Estate. It'll be 20 years in September. I never lived in a flat, and I certainly never lived in a high-rise building. I loved the flat, but I did feel very isolated because I didn't know nobody. But then when I was going over to the school and meeting people, and I'm just saying, well, they're just like myself.
We used to have to wash the landings once a week because there were 6 of us on the landing. They were spotless.
Like, in one sense, you knew everything that was going on because your window is better than the radio. I absolutely adored looking at it. The minute I get up in the morning, I'd be just looking at it, see that happen. I could see the whole Phoenix Park, the Pope's Cross and everything. You know, you had great views now.
So, summers was great, and the kids, they all played together, grew up together, and it was great. You sat in the playground until about 6 o'clock at night. You went up there and gave them their dinner and washed and dressed and put them to bed, you know. And you'd done the same thing the next day.
In the summer, we'd sit out with the kids. And the laughters. We'd be sitting down and some of us be knitting. There'd be camps all over the place. And then you'd hear someone roar out, me best friend, bring her up, there's a new blanket.
I moved into the estate, it was brilliant. There was loads of activities for the kids, you know, for us. There was playgrounds, the swings, slides, there was youth clubs, discos, summer projects. The estate was great at that time.
Sharon Wynne and Michelle Keogh, and there used to be an extended gang, Martin Ward, Christopher Gordon, Jason McKenna, Brian Bolton, Jeff Tunstead and Stokey. We played football every single night. And at Christmas time, no matter how many kids was in the house, and at them days you'd have big families, but then Santa'd knock on the door in a red suit.
And you'd have a parcel. All the kids on the estate, and it might have been only sweets or something like that there, but it really made the kids feel like very special because Santa knew their names.
I'm with the builder, the best builder there ever was.
Well, see, what happens, there's some good people here now. They offered them £5,000. They built a place out in Clontarkin, and they were offered to, they could buy them, and they were getting a grant of £5,000.
People were getting houses and moving in. A lot of the tenants association moved out at that time, like Felice Larkin and that, they all moved out.
And all of a sudden, the place changed completely.
You could get a complete stranger beside you, but if you had someone that you knew, you were kind of more safe. And I think that's what kind of brought the flats down.
How we all got together as a group around the drugs issue was 18 years ago, and every block had its residential drug pusher, and that was like the match that started us all off. The kids was watching this was happening. So a few of us got together and just said, look, we're not putting up with this. Then we used to hold meetings.
It was in the community centre, and you might have up to 200, 300 people there.
And we used to walk around the estate. I went into labour actually one night walking around the estate. That's 18 years ago.
To sit down there at the end of the road there at the youth centre, and you'd have a barrel, and they'd light that fire in the barrel, and it'd be there all night.
Around the early 80s, I remember one march that stuck out, and they got the guy out who was doing the gear, you know.
And I think what was happening was what was happening all over the city, was everyone was becoming aware of the impact of drugs, not just in Michael's estate.
Well, it died out because we were very strong, and maybe we were very naive when we thought the drug problem ceased, but it didn't, it just went underground. And I'd say it was really the kids that got me into being active in the estate.
Between us all then, that's how we started the U Project and we started Number 70. Well, we opened the Family Resource Centre in September of the next year, 85.
Now, the resort centre, the after schools, the arts and crafts for the kids. I mean, a few years ago you didn't have anything like that.
Well, I was involved in the resort centre here. You could come over and talk to somebody here you could come to. And got involved then, I got a job then up in the nursery from being known.
We've 10 years with the Resource Centre now, and we do great things. We've done the exhibition, and we do history classes, loads of things.